So yeah, we'll crack on now, and we'll see you in Bridlington in 20 hours time. Welcome to today's episode. Today we are going to do Way of the Roses, Morecambe to Bridlington, and yeah, maybe a little bit more if we do well. If we're not doing well, then well, we'll have to plan and see how we get on. Way of the Roses is Morecambe to Bridlington, 170 miles, 274 kilometres, coast to coast cycle route. Hopefully we're not going to be raining too much in the morning, because this is the hilly bit coming up in the first 40-50 miles, I think. It's forecast to be the only part of the UK, I think, which is actually going to be raining today. The wind is extremely strong, so we'll just have to hope that it blows in our favour. Anyway, yeah, hope you enjoy it. I'll catch you in a few minutes. We're about 23 miles in so far. Little bit of rain, a lot of wind. I think we've done about three hills so far, three of 20. I've got one coming up in a minute, a little one, he says. And then I think we've got about a few more miles, and then there's a big ooking one. Hopefully we're gonna have another stop at 40 miles just to grab 5 minutes and then go from there really. But yeah, not a bad ride so far. All is well so far. Absolutely stunning scenery, as we can see over here. Can't argue that. I think I'm about 6 miles from Settle, I think. Yeah, we've got about another 2 miles on this road, then we're turning off. So yeah, all cool. Right, I better plod on. Spot for this Way of the Roses, 18, I think it was a 12 18%. The road sign said 20%, but actually it was more like 18.9. I think it even topped out at 19. It was a 16% as well. There we are, look, there's a car struggling. It is our graft. Yeah, what a view though. Doesn't help much that I decided on the big fat fry up for second breakfast at Settle. I knew this hill was here, but stupidly I just forgot about it. Yeah, I knew the hill was there, but I completely forgot that it was literally right next to Settle. So I've got a big fat belly with a fry up in it, which is great, by the way. The world's most expensive fry up. I think I paid about £19, £18 for a fry up, a cup of coffee, and a mango juice. tracking down makes a change, it's normally up. I think now the climbs are getting longer. That last one was about a mile, the one before that was about 3.2 miles. And yeah, so I think that's probably how they get around there. You've got loads of climbing to do. No, you've only got a few because obviously they're all stupendously long. Regardless though, I think we're heading towards Rippenish area now. I'm not sure if I'm on time, behind time. I'm guessing we're behind time. But then again, I'm not really pushing the clock on this one. I will be using the full 24 hours of the day. And we'll see how this goes. So it's I'm not in no mad dash at the moment to actually start racing around, especially around here. It certainly does look a bit flatter that way. So there we go, we've got the signpost over there, we've got Otley that way, Summerbridge that way, Ripon left, Pateley Bridge, which is where I've just been, to be fair. Had some ice cream at Pateley Bridge, very nice. Crap coffee, mind you, but hey ho, you can't have everything. I'm guessing we're going to be going over yonder, over that way, and then possibly, I'm guessing down there. That just looks so lovely, all flat. Well, I bet it's not, but it certainly is flatter than where I've been. Current stats at the moment. Let's have a look. Yeah, 66.2 miles. My God, 6 hours and 23 minutes. Oh my God, so that's 10 miles an hour average, give or take. 10.5, I think that is. I haven't got the averages turned on for some reason. I reset the Karoo before I started this journey because I've got fed up with the annoying little beep beeps on the power and whatnot. So I've reset it and it doesn't tell me the average speed now. Or worse, it doesn't tell me the average height climbed as well. Doesn't tell me. It doesn't also tell me about the elevation gain, what I've climbed. So I'm guessing if we're halfway done on the climbs, I think it's about 9,000 feet for the Bridlington to Morecambe bit. So I can safely say I've probably done about 4,000 feet already, I would guess. Although I'm not going to bank on it. Right, we're going to plod on. It's coming up to 4 o'clock. So we've got 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Got another 5 more hours of daylight. And then we're going to be running into darkness. So what I'm going to do is probably use all the daylight possible. And then I'm going to take a couple of hours break. Probably just take a bench, grab some coffee and some snacks, just feed up, rest. A couple of hours is perfect. And then probably about 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock in the morning, push forward again. Hopefully the roads will be absolutely empty the way I'm going. Make sure we've got enough water before we do. And then, use the lights for 3 hours, so that should take me to at least 2-3 o'clock minimum, probably more, and then if need be use the backup light, take me an extra hour, so that'll take me to about 4:30, maybe 4 o'clock, 4:30, have a quick rest, and then we've got daylight I believe at 5:30, and then we've got about a good hour and a half push before we run out on 24 hours. Almost 9 hours, riding time. As predicted, we're almost coming up to the 100 mile mark. And it's awful time. I think it's about 10.5 average so far. It's been pretty flat for the last 20 miles or so. We're about, 8-9 miles away from York. It's 7:30 in the evening. Hoping to hit York in the next 30 minutes or so, 35 maybe. Need to pick up a few supplies, some food, and hopefully an iPhone cable as well, because I stupidly brought the wrong one, so I'm running on like 30% of battery life. Completely useless tool. Of course, we're going to be coming up to the York cycleways in a few moments. Last time I was in York, I come over here, set the sun is in your eyes. Last time I was in York, it was great, but just so confusing. But I must say, the signs for the Way of the Roses have been absolutely excellent so far. When you look at the distance left, I know the total mileage is about 170 miles from Morecambe all the way across. Commute's telling me I've only got about another 52 miles, I'm going to presume, because I'm using the cycle network. It's going to take me around the houses off the beaten track. I must resist not to divert and just go on an A road, especially at night. Just north of York, and it's like deja vu all over again. I've rejoined the same route as I did for the Newcastle to Lincoln ride. And I'm like, this all looks very, very familiar. And I'm, oh, of course it is, yeah. I even quoted it on, I think Rad with Roy did Way of the Roses. And I'm like, I've been on that path around York. We're just about to hit York now. I've just had a quick look at the stats. Currently 104.8 miles. So, yep, number 15 for the 200K. Nice and easy there, quite happy. Ride time 9 hours 20 minutes, which I think is going to be fine. I've just had a closer look at the map. We've got 3 more substantial climbs to do before Bridlington. And luckily, they're towards Bridlington, which is nice. In comparison, I've done really well. I'm quite pleased that I've actually got past this far, got to this point already, which is absolutely outstanding. So yeah, I'm looking forward to this last 60 odd miles. I am desperately trying to get this done within the 24 hour time period. That way I can claim I've done it in a day, which would be fantastic. I think the next time you hear from me is gonna be when it's a little bit pitch black. Six in the morning. I've been awake 24 hours. I've been riding since just gone after 7 yesterday. Worst night ever. It's so cold. Anyway, good news is we're here. Yep. Looks like we're going to be doing it. I think I departed yesterday, I'm not sure, might be wrong on this. I'm sure it was 7:15, might have been 7. So I'll have to adjudicate. Well, I've enjoyed myself in Bridlington for all of about 26 minutes. I'm now gonna catch a train back to Hull. I was gonna cycle it, but I'm freezing. 12 degrees at the moment, and I feel like I'm absolutely shivering from last night. So I'm gonna go sit on the train for 45 minutes and warm up. Anyway, if you like what you see, please do click like, comment, subscribe, and as always, see you in the next video. Bye bye.